This video series is brought to you by Laoghaire-Rathdown Libraries in association with Mark the Science Guy and supported by the Dormant Accounts Fund. The resources used throughout this series are part of the SFI Discover Primary Science and Maths programme and Azero Ireland. Hey everyone and welcome back to the STEAM Lab. I've been taking a little lunch break and staring at this toaster and it's got me thinking about energy. We get our energy from food. If I eat the toast, my body changes it into energy. I can then do things. So, I get energy from the food, but where does the toaster get its energy from? Well, it gets its energy from electricity. And most electricity in Ireland comes from gas-powered stations. But power can also be created in other stations too, some of which are better for the planet than others. Using these different forms of fuel helps make sure that we don't run out of power. So let's investigate where our electricity comes from.
Oh, hi Mark!
What kind of toaster is this?
Oh, Mark, it is so windy out there today. I was up at the top of the hill and the wind was so strong that it almost knocked me over.
I can tell, you got leaves everywhere. Yeah. You make a good point though, Ali. Wind can be strong and we can get energy from the wind. Nowadays, more and more power is being generated by renewable energy. This can come from the wind turning the blades of a wind turbine, or from the sun shining, and from generators powered by waves or the tides. And this is much better for the planet.
If you've ever seen a big white windmill on the top of a hill in Ireland, then you've seen renewable energy in action. Mm. So the windmills take energy from the wind and they change it into electricity. The electricity then goes to your toaster. Mm-hmm. Toaster heats your bread. You eat the toast. Energy for everyone.
Oh, what setting I put this toaster on. Electricity is made in a generator, which can be powered in lots of ways. We can burn coal, oil, gas, and peat to heat the water. This makes steam, which can turn the turbine and generate electricity.
Or we can run flowing water over a turbine, or the wind can push the blades of a windmill. And once you can get something spinning, then you've got the power to make electricity.
Yes, but not all ways of making electricity were created equal. Let's take a closer look at the different sources of energy we can use.
We can split energy sources into two big groups, renewable and non-renewable. Renewable energy uses sources that are not used up or won't run out. For example, solar power from the sun is renewable as we won't use up all of the sunlight from the sun. If we harvest energy from the sun today, it'll still shine tomorrow, hopefully.
Non-renewable energy sources include things like coal, gas, and oil. We call these fossil fuels, and once we burn these, they're gone forever, meaning they'll eventually run out. So a lot of the world uses non-renewable energy to heat their homes, power their devices, run their cars. And in Ireland, over 95% of our energy comes from non-renewable sources of energy. That's a lot.
That is a lot. Fossil fuels might be great for heating our homes, but unfortunately, they're not so great for the earth. When we burn fossil fuels, they release huge amounts of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, which has really negative effects on our planet.
Renewable energy sources are better for the environment than burning fossil fuels. They produce only a tiny fraction of the pollution that burning fossil fuels give out. And switching to these will help protect the environment and provide us with cleaner air and water.
So Mark, if renewable sources of energy are the future, then we better learn a bit more about them. Without the sun, we just wouldn't be here. There'd be absolutely no life on Earth. Plants use the sun to make food. We eat the plants. We survive.
The sun also gives us light and heat, and we can use its power to make electricity. We call this solar power. Mm. And gadgets called solar panels capture the sun's energy. And there are two kinds of solar panel. Some solar panels use the heat from the sun to heat homes and water, and other solar panels turn the sun's energy into electricity. And these are called photovoltaic cells, or sometimes solar cells.
Now, Mark, you've already had your lunch, but I'm feeling pretty peckish. So let's try and harness the sun's energy to make a solar-powered oven.
Delicious.
So to make your very own solar oven, what you will need is a box with a lid. You will need some cling film, some black paper, some tin foil, a scissors, some tape, and some glue.
Cool.
Okay.
I'm hungry. So,
oh, good. Okay, so the first step is you're going to need to cut a flap in the lid of your box. So just cut along three sides so that it opens up like this. Make sure you leave a little bit of space though between the cuts of the flap and the edge of the box. Now, first thing we need to do is make sure that the sunlight is going to directly go into the box. So to do that, we're going to use some tin foil. So tape some tin foil to the inside of that flap in the box. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna reflect the sun's light into the box. Try and keep the tin foil as flat as you can. So once you have that in place, just use a bit of tape to stick it down. It should look something like this. Now, we're going to be leaving this outside in the sun. So we want to make sure that the dirt and the bugs don't get inside there. So this hole here is going to be a bit of a problem. Yep. So what we're going to do is we're going to use some of that cling film to block off the hole. So Mark, if you could stretch the cling film over the hole there, and you hold that in place.
Yes.
I will tape it down.
Ooh, clingy.
So let's put a bit of tape on the side there like that.
Got to keep the bugs out.
We'll use a few bits of tape just to secure that cling film in place. Now we want to make sure that the heat is going to be absorbed inside the box. And for that, we're going to use some black paper because black is really good at absorbing heat.
Yes.
So just cut a piece of black paper so that it fits inside your box and then you can glue it down to the bottom. A little bit of glue. Pop your paper in and it should look something like that.
Awesome.
Okay. And now it's pretty much ready to go.
Yes.
If you want to try and keep more heat inside your box, this is optional, but what you can do is take some newspaper and tape it around the inside of the box, and that will just kind of keep some of that heat inside. Now, your solar powered oven can be whatever size you like. This is obviously quite a small one.
Yeah, little.
You can make some bigger ones like this. You can make them out of things like pizza, takeaway pizza boxes.
That is very cool.
Yeah. So what's going to happen is you're going to take your solar oven outside in the afternoon between like 12 and 3 tends to be like the hottest part of the day. Yeah. So find the sunny spot, put your solar oven down, pop your food inside, whatever it is you want to heat up, and then angle this flap to make sure that it directs the sunlight into the box. You can hold it up with like a ruler or something like that to prop it up. So what kind of things would you put in your solar oven?
I think
oven?
It's got to be cookies. You've got to make
cookies,
some sort of cookies.
Yeah, some sort of warm dessert.
Camping trip type things.
Ooh, some chocolate and some marshmallows and some biscuits maybe.
I like
maybe.
How you're thinking. S'mores. Ooh, very cool.
Yeah.
All this talk of the sun's energy was getting me a little bit thirsty as well though. Let's see how water can be used to make some more electricity. S'more? Electricity?
Let's just move on.
Solar oven. Water can be insanely powerful. Have you ever seen the damage a flood can cause or stood near a waterfall and heard its roar?
Arr.
That power can be used to make electricity called hydroelectricity. In hydroelectric power plants, water is collected high up on a hill or a mountain and then falls down through pipes. Falling water makes wheels called turbines spin. These turbines run generators, which make us electricity.
We can also get electricity from the oceans. Mm-hmm. Here in Ireland, we have a pretty wild coastline full of waves that surfers love.
Yes, we do.
Those same waves can be used to make electricity. The best waves in Europe are found along western coasts by the Atlantic Ocean, like along Ireland's west coast. They don't call it the Wild Atlantic Wave for nothing.
Using the power of water is not a new idea. Water power has been used for thousands of years. Ancient Romans used it to grind grain. Hmm. So let's see how we can make our own water wheel.
To make your own water wheel, what you're going to need is a plastic bottle. You'll need some wire, like a piece of a wire coat hanger. You'll need something to poke a hole with, like a corkscrew. And you're also going to need a sharp knife or scissors. So we recommend having adult supervision for this one. And then the last thing you're going to need is a cork.
Mm-hmm.
So the first step to making your water wheel.
Need something to chop your water bottle in half?
Yes.
Got it. Karate chop.
That was impressive.
Oh,
okay, so cut the top off your water bottle. Very nice. And just put that to the side for now. Don't get rid of it fully, but put it to the side. What you're going to need to do then is punch two holes on either side of the bottom of your water bowl. Make sure they're big enough that your wire can fit through and spin freely like that. That's going to be important because the spinning is what's going to power our water wheel. So once you've done that, you need to prep your cork. Okay? So what you're going to need to do is get an adult to help you to poke a hole all the way through your cork from end to end, and then get them to cut 6 slices along the side of the cork. It should look something like this. So 6 cuts along your cork like that all the way around. Now, bring back your old piece of bottle. What you're going to need to do is you're going to need to cut the blades of your water wheel from this. So cut out little squares or rectangles of plastic. They should be something a little bit like this, okay? Little small squares or rectangles of plastic. And now you're ready to assemble your water wheel. Take those blades for your water wheel that you cut, and you're going to stick them into those slits that you made inside the cork. So once you've got all six on, they should look a little bit something like this.
Very cool.
All six blades into your cork like that. Now, putting it together is really simple. Thread the wire through one side of your bottle. Really simple. What you're going to do is push the wire through one of the holes. Thread the wire through those holes in your cork. And then push it back out the other side again. So your cork will sit just in the middle like that. So when you're cutting the blades for your water turbine, it's important to make sure that they're not too big. Otherwise, it won't be able to spin freely like this. And then you're ready to add in your water. We painted the blades here. So Mark, I think we both have some water here. So yeah. Let's test them and make sure they work.
Let's get it turning. Okay.
Okay.
Got our water.
Right, you ready?
Spin that water wheel.
Okay, here we go.
Check that out. Speedy little thing. Flies around.
And there you have it. That's how you make your very own water wheel. You're making a mess.
Hydroelectricity. That's very cool. So we've seen how sun and water can make electricity. Mm-hmm. But let's check out how we can get electricity from wind.
Just got the leaves out of my hair.
It was a good look for you. I think you should go back to it. Okay. It's the autumn look. It's fall.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go investigate.
Bring back the leaves.
Wind energy is a clean, sustainable solution to our energy problems. There will always be wind, and in Ireland, about 30% of the electricity we use comes from the wind.
Oh, we can make electricity from the wind using wind turbines. They're tall towers topped with blades, like those big white ones you see out in the hills in the countryside. When the wind blows, the blades spin, and this spinning powers a generator which makes electricity. And a group of wind turbines together is called a wind farm. Bit different than a farm with full of cows and sheep, though.
I would love to see a sheepdog trying to like herd a load of wind turbines together.
I bet you would. Yeah.
Let's have a go at making our very own wind turbines. Mm-hmm. Hold on to your hats. It's about to get breezy in here.
Ugh.
No?
We cut that line out.
Okay. To make your very own wind turbine, what you're going to need is a sheet of paper cut into a square. You can use coloured paper or white paper, whatever you like. You're going to need scissors. You're going to need a pencil, and you're going to need a thumbtack. First thing you need to do is you need to find the center point of your square. Once you've found it, just mark it with your pencil. So you got a little dot just in the center there. Now, what you're gonna do is with your scissors, you are going to cut from the corner towards the center point. Don't go all the way, leave a little bit of a gap. So cutting from each of the four corners towards that center point. And you can make your windmill whatever size you like, whatever color you like. Now what you can do is you can kind of think of it as you have eight different points. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring those points in towards the center to make our windmill shape. So grab your thumbtack, be nice and careful with these because they are sharp, and take one of your points and push the thumbtack through the outside of the paper like that. Skip the next point and grab the next one and do the same thing again, pushing the thumbtack through the outside of the point. Skip the next point, grab the next one and push your thumbtack through. Skip the next point and then grab the last one and push your thumbtack through. Once you have all of your corners gathered together, push your thumbtack through that center point and you should have something that looks a little bit like this. Now, last step is to put a handle onto your windmill so that you can hold onto it and it can blow. Push your thumbtack into the side of your pencil and that should hold it all together like that.
We got our wind turbine.
Yeah. Okay, and now what you can do is you can bring them outside if it's a windy day, or you can use your natural breath and just blow on it and it should spin.
That is awesome.
They're pretty cool, aren't they?
Awesome.
So we can have our very own wind farm.
Cool colours as well. Get creative, get fun. Make some big ones, make some small ones, make some different colours. So we've seen how we can make electricity from renewable sources of energy like the sun, wind, and water. And we need to continue to get more of our energy from these sources. There are some really simple things we can all do at home right now to help the planet.
Why not make an effort to turn off the lights whenever you leave the room or turn off the TV when you're finished with it? We can all make an effort to reduce, reuse and recycle our waste, and we should all try and walk or cycle to school wherever possible.
These little changes may not seem like much, but they'll make a big difference to the planet.
The planet deserves it, I think.
It does. Thanks again, everyone, for joining us today in the STEAM Lab. We hope you enjoyed all our investigations and definitely try out a few yourself. All of these resources we used today are available on the SFI Discover Primary Science and Maths website, primaryscience.ie.
Got any toast left?
Where is the toast, actually?
Let's go find the toast.
I'm gonna get the toast.
Bye.
This video series is brought to you by Laoghaire-Rathdown Libraries in association with Mark the Science Guy and supported by the Dormant Accounts Fund. The resources used throughout this series are part of the SFI Discover Primary Science and Maths programme and Azero Ireland.